Workspace ONE UEM offers an iOS updates management framework that provides IT admins with the tools they require to maintain the OS across corporate-owned iOS devices in their fleet. OS update management leverages Apple APIs to display a list of all available updates and manage those updates on the devices using the native management commands in iOS. In this video, I'll show you how to use Workspace ONE to manage iOS updates. To start, click on Resources, Device Updates, and then iOS. The first view lists all available iOS versions as reported by Apple. Each row shows the specific version, its release and expiration date, and whether the update is still available for deployment to the devices. Clicking on an update displays a dashboard that provides specific details about this update, like the hardware model supported by this update, and a device readiness graph showing how many devices are eligible for this update. To begin assigning this update to devices, you'll select Manage Assignments. On this screen, you can create one or more new assignments and prioritize the assignments in the event a device falls into multiple assignment groups. I'll talk more about prioritization in a moment. You'll click New Assignment to assign this update to a group of devices. Give the assignment a name. In this example, I'll call it iOS 16.5 Update. Select one or more smart groups and click Next. You can select the date and time to begin deploying the update. Now, this represents the date and time when Workspace ONE will begin sending the update commands to the devices. You have three options for how the deployment should be executed. You can combine the OS update download and install steps, meaning that Workspace ONE would automate the entire update process. However, if you want more granular control, you can separately trigger a command to download and stage the update locally on the device, and a separate command to perform the iOS upgrade at a later time. Clicking Next provides options for notifying the end user on the device through Intelligent Hub. You also have the option to customize the message delivered to the user. Now click Save to finish adding the assignment. With the assignment saved, you can create more assignments if required. Multiple assignments can come in handy in the case of a phased rollout from your alpha testing group to a beta testing group and then into production. In the event that you have multiple assignments, you can rearrange and save the priority of those assignments. Priority adjustments can be useful if you have devices belonging to multiple assignments based on their smart group membership. The priority settings help Workspace ONE know which schedule takes priority for these devices. Keep in mind, if you assign a device to multiple different iOS versions, Workspace ONE will only attempt to deploy the latest version of iOS to which the device is assigned. Back on the update dashboard, you can refresh the screen to see the list of all assigned devices populated and the device status graph updated as well. You can select individual devices to force a query or an assignment override. For instance, you can force a device to download an update immediately instead of waiting for the scheduled assignment to complete. Something else to remember, you can always pause an update, which will stop Workspace ONE from issuing any update-related commands to devices. This can come in handy if you need to pause a rollout to troubleshoot an updated-related issue. Now keep in mind, devices that are online and have already received a command to download or install the update will continue to perform the assigned action.